we'd always just adapt with what music was in the air, and we'd just adapt.
It was the dance thing at the time, and we, being such great dancers, all of us.
Yeah, and we thought it was just another beat, you know, we could do disco. I'm only just getting into the Bee Gees. I used to hate them. I heard Night Fever, Night Fever. Heard that the other day. And even that's quite good, actually. Was another change the band was going through and evolving into the next round, round 12, you know, round 13, round 14, here we go.
So it's not like songs like Miss You came out of frustration because what people said and because you were...
Well, it may have done from Mick's point of view, but for me, no. It was a question of trying to help him write a song by playing the drums with him. That's all it is, really. It's called being a band. We didn't see Paris, to be honest, apart from sitting in a restaurant having some escargot or whatever.
Yeah, all I know is we were trapped in Boulogne-Billancourt Studios. We did Tattoo You, apparently, Emotional Rescue, apparently, that album. But they were all, and some girls, but we were just turning out music, that's all it was. Like, more tracks, more, and these got used for this album, and then... This got used for this album. That's what we do, we just churn out music.
Going to the studio for 2 days when Keith had let you out to go to sleep for half a day and then you'll be oiked back in.
Come on, nobody sleeps while I'm awake. Yeah, break into my house and drag me out of bed. And then get me down to the studio and you'd already be there. And then poor old Bill Wyman, he just settled into his first night's sleep in ages. And we'd get the marching orders to get out of bed, get back down the studio.
Bill, they start coming round about now. I think I better get back in my case.
Drinking drugs is what you're...
That's about
how you got over it.
Yeah.
That was the only way you got round it, really.
How would both of you describe your role in the band by that time?
Guitar and drummer, I would have thought.
Slaves.
You're not a replaceable drummer in the band?
Yeah.
No.
No.
You? No. Come on, I've seen too much.
Well, not now, because it's all gone by the time.
It's all history.
At the time, you could have been, but I play with them, you know, but if I was playing with Ronnie and his famous band, I would consider what I did a contribution to that, you know. I mean, it's nothing, it's not.
And you're nodding.
He's going to underestimate himself, isn't he? But you know, we couldn't go anywhere without him.
And how about you? Your role in the band?
Well, Charlie said I brought laughter to the band and a bit of melody, I think. And if I can bring that, then
he's great in the studio, actually.
It was just me and Keith. We were joined at the hip at that time. Well, we always are when we play. But that's why he liked me in the band. It's because a lot of it we didn't have to tear apart and say, look, you're doing this wrong. You know, it was kind of, I know Ronnie's going to know what to do because I'm going to do this, you know. So, you know, after a while, a man gets to look like his dog. It rubs off.